Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to discuss the importance of Kuroda's identities for the implementation of filter. Friends, we have studied in the previous video, that is Richard transformation. Richard transformation is used to transform a lumped component into the distributed components at microwave frequencies. For example, if you consider a ladder circuit L and a C. This is L and a C. We have studied that in a Richard transformation, inductor is represented by short circuit stub and the capacitor is represented by open circuit stub. So this is a transmission line. Now we realize the inductor at a micro frequency. Inductor is realized by using a short circuit line. So this is a short circuit. This is a length L. L equal to lambda by 8 and impedance Z0, it is equal to L. And capacitance is represented by open circuit. This is a open circuit. Length L equal to lambda by 8 and Z0 equal to 1 by 6. So this is a realization. But at the same time, the distance or spacing between two stubs plays a very, very important role at the time of implementation of a filter. This spacing directly affects the performance of a filter. So this problem can be overcome by using a Kuroda's identities. What Kuroda has done, he inserted a separate transmission line segment between the two stubs. Because of that, these are physically separated to each other. Even though adding the extra transmission line segment between the two stubs, it does not affect the performance of the filter. So this is a Kuroda's identities. Now by using these identities we will get other advantages also. So first, already we have discussed physically separate the transmission line stubs by adding a extra transmission line. Even though we add a additional transmission line section, do not affect the filter response. At the same time, you can transform series stubs into shunt stubs, or you can shunt stubs to series stubs. Change impractical characteristic impedance into a realizable values. We'll get these advantages by using the Kuroda's identities. Generally, four Kuroda's identities are used for these purposes. So, first Kuroda's identities, in that we connect a capacitor in parallel to a unit element. This is a unit element. See here, if capacitor comes first, then you represent it as a Z2, right? It is a 1 upon Z2. So Z2 comes first, then after that Z1. So this is a unit element. Then we know that Kuroda's identity transform shunt to the series stub or series to the shunt stub. Now we convert shunt to the series stub. How do we convert this? You see here, I draw unit element first. Then after that, capacitor is converted into the inductor. So first is a Z2, right here Z2, then this is a Z1. So for inductor, you should write Z1 by N square divided by N square. If inductor is there, if divided by N square, you also divide unit element impedance Z2 by N square. Now we'll see the second identity. In a second identity, we consider inductor in series. So I draw, this is inductor in series. It is Z1. When inductor comes first, it is represented as Z1. Unit element is a Z2. Now we transform into the product identity, series becomes a shunt. So first we draw unit element, then inductor becomes a capacitance. So this is the capacitance. So first we write this is Z1, and capacitor is represented as 1 upon Z2. Keep in mind, capacitance is represented as 1 upon Z2 per capacitor multiplied by N square. So write 1 upon N square Z2, and this is a N square Z1. Now see the third identity. In the third identity, we keep inductor in a shunt branch. So we draw this. So right here, when inductor comes first, then Z1. Then after that, unit element is a Z2. How do you transform this? I represent first unit element, then the inductor in parallel. When you show the inductor in shunt branch, compulsory at that time, a new part or new component is added, that is a transformer, which has turn ratio is 1 as N square. Then this is a Z1 and this is a Z2. Already I told you that when inductor comes, then Z2 divided by N square, and this is a Z1 divided by N square. Same part for a capacitance. Fourth identity. In that fourth identity, capacitor, we show here capacitor in parallel, then unit element, this is capacitance, we write here it is 1 upon Z2. Unit element is a Z1, capacitor comes first, so it is Z2 and a Z1. Now, Faraday's identities, transform into the Faraday's identities. So I show here first element is a unit element, then capacitor in parallel. I show capacitor in parallel. So at that time, show the transformer. This is a transformer. It is trans, it has a trans ratio N square as a 1. Then I Z2, and this is a capacitor is 1 upon Z1. for capacitor multiplication 1 upon n square z1, then n square z2. These are four Prodrug's identities are used for getting a different advantages. So see the realization of Prodrug's identities. For example, I take a simple example for realization purposes. I take the same previous example. So this is a capacitor, and this is a lead element. It is 1 upon Z2 and Z1. How do we realize it? We realize it by using element, lead element first, then after that series inductance, lead element Z2 and Z1 inductance Z1 by N square, Z2 by N square. Now see the Prodrug's identities, identities. How to implement using Prodrug's identities? So first, this is capacitor. By using Richter transformation, it acts as a open circuit. I'll show you first. I show the lead element. So this is a lead element. Lead element. Impedance of Z1. The length L. And capacitor is represented by open circuit. So this is an open circuit capacitance, length of L, and impedance is a Z2. Same part, how do we represent it by using the Prodrug's identities? So first unit element. So this is a unit element. It here unit element. Impedance Z2 by N square. Then inductor represented as a short circuit. So I'll show you. This is the inductor represented as a short circuit, which has impedance Z1 by N square. So this is a representation. This is a representation of Prodrug's identities. Thank you.